status. We have the hottest record in the world, like we always do at 7:30 on this show. And don't forget, the hottest record blog is up as well. bbc.co.uk/blogs/Zane Lowe. Tonight's hottest record was played last night, but it's that good. But you got us in a real spin with this piece of music, Mr. James Blake. We love it, man.
Thanks very much.
I know it's been around for a while. Giles Peterson was playing a version of this song, you know, a few months back now. And now we've got word that it is going to be sort of the first official single, kind of proper, from your forthcoming album. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's right. It's going to be on a 10-inch coming out sometime next month. This is, I suppose, the next sort of chapter. You know, the vocals come into the foreground and...
Yeah, it's fantastic. We're going to play it, come back and get a little more backstory on it and find out what the future holds for James Blake. The hottest record in the world today, as suggested by various people on my Twitter site who heard it last night, who were like, this needs to be hottest record. So you bang on the money. Here we go. This is James Blake and Limit to Your Love.
It's middle of the week, it's Wednesday night, y'all. With Zane Lowe. And it's about 7:30 p.m. and my man Zane is about to put on the hottest
show in
the world.
Oh! There's a limit to your love. Like a waterfall in slow motion. Like a map with no. There's a limit to your love. Your love, your love, your love. There's a limit to your care. So carelessly there. Is it truth or dare? There's a limit to your care. There's a limit to your love. Like a waterfall in slow motion. Like a map with no ocean. There's a limit to your love. Your love, your love, your love. There's a limit to your care. So carelessly there. Is it truth or care? There's a limit to your care. There's a limit to your care. So carelessly left. There's a limit to your care.
So originally a Fi song that's been really nicely interpreted by James Blake, and he's on the phone right now. And tell us a little bit about kind of how you came across this. Obviously, you heard Fi's version of it, but you know, it takes a little bottle to get involved and do your own version of it. Was it by chance, or did you really, when you first heard it, think I could do something special with that?
I originally just wanted to cover it as a sort of piano and vocal song. I think I recorded it and then went home, and I just had the raw recordings. Decided to try some of the techniques that I'd used, like, you know, with a lot of the electronic stuff. I just wanted to cover it at first, but it turned into something else.
It must have been really nice to know that as an artist, you know, even though some of your earlier releases suggested that you were more in a producer, you know, frame of mind, that, you know, you had this voice and you had these songs and you had this stuff to unveil at some point.
It didn't really occur to me that it would unfold how it has. I just had quite a varied output, I suppose. It never really hit me that the vocal stuff would have the impact that it does. You know, so I didn't really expect any of this to happen.
That's perfect. And we're the lucky ones, James, just for the record, because these records make our, you know, make our days that much more enjoyable. It's just such a wonderful listen. You know, it's a you know, first proper single from James Blake. I think November is earmarked for the release of the song properly. And it's called Limit to Your Love, and you're going to hear it a lot more on this show, no doubt, across various shows on Radio 1. And it's really nice to talk to you finally. And thanks again for the music, James. We'll speak to you again very soon, I hope.
Thanks, Zane.
Like a waterfall in slow. Quite an amazing piece of work there. I mean, obviously, his voice and his playing, his ability as a musician is there. That is set in stone. You can identify that from the first notes. The original track by Feist is amazing in itself. So, like I said, having a go at a song like that takes some confidence, takes some bottle. But then the way he structured it, the way he's let it breathe and given it so much space and made all the vocals and the choruses overlap each other, and somehow it all just makes perfect sense. And that's why people are responding 8-1-9 like this. There's no one in the world right now apart from me and this song. There's a text from Vicky in Cambridge. She's in the moment. OMG, wow, from Ianka. What a fantastic voice. That's from 829. Beautiful song. That's from Nick in Bristol. And the reaction we got last night when we played it was amazing as well. Hottest record in the world, up and on the blog.